Hi, in this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to RAM preview so you can play back your animation after you've customized your template. So if you're unfamiliar with After Effects, but more familiar with video editing software, it'll be a little bit weird to not be able to just play the video. In After Effects, it actually needs to process each frame and then if you have a newer versions of After Effects, it caches those frames onto your hard drive so you can play them back. And so what you need to do is do a RAM preview. The first thing you want to do is look in our timeline and make sure that our work area is set to start and finish for the entire duration of the timeline, if that's what you want to see. So if you can see my cursor here, I'm pulling on this yellow rectangle, and this is the beginning of my work area. And so if I wanted just a RAM preview, just the first 15 seconds, I can pull this around our timeline. There's also keyboard shortcuts, so if you want to hit N, and that will set your work area to end wherever your current time indicator is. So let's say we moved it over here and hit N. So it's just an easy little shortcut there. And if you wanted to not start at zero, but start like around 5 seconds, you can hit B on your keyboard. And now you have the work area start, begin for B at your current time indicator. Now that we have our work area set, we're going to take a look at our comp viewer, and we're gonna set our resolution to half. You can set it to full, but it will take longer. And you can also set it to a quarter if you just wanted to see the timing and resolution was not a big factor. But half is usually pretty good just for the purposes of previewing something. Now you can either go to Composition, Preview, and select RAM Preview. That's one way to do it. You can also hit zero on your keyboard, numbers keypad, and that will start the RAM preview. And as you can see in our work area, we have this green progress bar. And you'll see that it is a little slow depending on how much RAM you have allocated to After Effects. It could be faster or slower. But since this is the first time After Effects is previewing or processing these frames, it might be a little bit slow. So when After Effects is done processing all those frames in your work area, it will immediately play back your timeline. And if you hit spacebar, you can stop it. Now, if you hit spacebar again, it's just going to do the play forward and you might not hear your audio. So you want to hit zero again on your numbers keypad. And that usually starts from the beginning. So we stopped it and hit zero. It's going to start over from zero. If you go up to your preview panel, if you don't have that open, you can go to Window, Preview. And we have some playback buttons here, and you can use this button that's to the far right. That is your RAM preview button. So if you just wanted to click that button instead of using the keyboard shortcut, you can do that. There's also, I'm using After Effects CC2012. There's an option here that says from current time. So you can move your current time indicator and check that box, and it'll play back from your current time indicator instead of playing back from your work area. If you've already seen the first 5 seconds and it looks good to you, then you won't need to just keep re-watching that. You can always move your work area start time, or just click from current time and then just move your current time indicator where you want it to start and then hit the RAM preview button. Just to show you really quick in the timeline in our work area, you'll see that the section that we already RAM previewed is blue. So there's this blue area. That just means that After Effects has cached those frames. So if you, let's say you wanted to preview from there, unclick from current time, it'll load those frames a lot faster because it's already processed those frames. So you'll see that as you're working with After Effects and RAM previewing, you'll see green, you'll see blue, and all the blue means is that After Effects has already cached those frames, and when you play it back, it should work a lot faster.